Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Anticipation is mounting for today's game, and we've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Lux Colts going up against Cutler's Bears. So let's send you up to Chicago, where we'll say hello to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Indianapolis Colts and the Chicago Bears. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And off we go from Soldier Field. This is fielded at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step in.
Double tight, guys. Double tight.
Hey.
They come out with one back and three tight ends.
Mike, hurry.
Check 99. Check 99.
One receiver left is Hilton.
Easy.
Switch.
And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Offense with a fumble, but they recover it, and it brings up second down.
Move. I got four down.
Here's Lightwell on second down. Looking for Allen. He's got him on the slam. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Call it a pickup of seven, and that'll make it third down.
Partners, a lot of fun. It used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and nine.
We got three.
Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and nine.
I got it.
This is the West Coast. This is our way.
Get up here. Get up here.
59.
Easy.
Come on, y'all. Let's go. Get up. Get on your feet.
Key right.
Alert.
No. Off.
Throwing on third down. Long. Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bears sack. Pernell McPhee. He's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of five, and it'll bring up fourth down. Gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Two combination look pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
And now a first down following that long
end.
Gain.
Down.
Check. Lucky.
Get out.
Isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in a ball game. And in this case,
trying to punch it in with power. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defensive front there. They held their ground. Pretty much stoned him on that play.
Kill.
And ended up creating a loss.
it 7-0 in favor of the Bears. After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically, what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Now a first down throw, Luck. And this is what here? Incomplete, they say. It looked like it was intercepted, but he apparently did not get the 2 feet down in bounds. And a lot of the weight of this offense falls on the shoulders of the running back.
That's because the offense knows if they give him any openings, any opportunities, he could turn it into a big play at any time.
10 yards still left on second down.
Come on, baby. Get excited. Let's go. Come on, baby. Get on your feet.
Tempo, tempo, tempo.
Check 59. Mike.
Back to the air. Locked on second down. Philip Dorsett hauls it in. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from. And that's what he did.
And it's a short one, complete to his tight end. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
For possibly another 1,000-yard season, it would be his ninth.
I talked with a GM in the league, and all he talked about was when I was coming up through the ranks, people would always say, if you get your team to be just like Frank Gore, everyone you draft, you'd have a heck of a team. Incredible work ethic, will to win, and obviously tremendous production.
Yeah, production this year, 532 yards through the 8 games to start the season.
Double tight, double tight.
They come out with one back and three timeouts. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
But we always talk about good down and distance, allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more of a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Let's go,
D.
Let's go.
They'll try the air now with Locke. Over the middle, Dorsett. And he's brought down. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a 1st and goal.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Right through. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
First down with Cutler. That's complete. And time and a new set of downs.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
So the offense has it first and 10.
Tight end. Watch tight end. Watch tight end. Key him. Key the tight end.
Gun.
Check.
180.
Right.
Under.
Shift together here from the D-line. On first down, it's Cutler. He's going to rifle one deep. And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Chicago. Alshon Jeffrey, 63 yards. And the Bears are able to show off their quick strike ability. And that there, that was just a fly route. There was no stop. He just went.
Yeah, and it was beautiful to watch, because you have to set it up as you go along. Everyone knows he's fast, so you play him for that. That's the number one thing you want to take away. But as you go through a game, sometimes you vary the speed in which you come off the line of scrimmage and maybe start a little bit slower, get him to stop his feet a little bit as a defensive back, and then explode and go, as we saw there.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard, because now their confidence is level. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent. But you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
Keep this drive alive.
They'll need eight yards here on third down.
Watch 40.
Get high.
Easy.
catches was thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. That's taken on the 25. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Bears take over. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
Watch
it
right,
always
watch
is
right,
punch counter
right.
Punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage?
Let's go, D.
Let's just come back. Last
when
time
on
offense, you see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline
Shake
really
down.
Get into the game.
Down,
so defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from
Shut
them?
Down.
How do we
Shut
get
down.
The advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
Let's see if they dial it up this drive.
Cut his left. Cut his left.
They'll come
three
out
down.
In the
Under.
Pistol.
Check 24. Check 24.
Now coming to throw on second down. Hit as he throws there, incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver, and it's third and short.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete.
Single receiver. Hey, you're on an island over
and
there.
On third
single
down,
receiver.
The Colts have added an extra defensive back.
Hey, hey, hey.
Set in the passing
I got
lane.
Third and two, now Cutler. Looking left side, and it's complete. 15 yards through the air and a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping, and dragging to make
guys,
sure he gets
tight.
It done.
Down,
they come out
down.
Here
down.
In the eye. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
One receiver left, three
Check.
To the right.
Hey. Slam.
On second down, Cutler. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Eddie Royal is intended target, and it's third down. And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right.
57
Mike.
Check nickel.
Down as they bring him down at the 23.
Oh,
they pick up there at 20 yards.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you don't lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there. And then he's going to take the ball.
Second down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Offense walks to the line for play number seven of the drive. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Now it's Cutler. And he takes the 15 yards. And the Bears will add on to their lead. And on that one, able to catch it. Also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Lift the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. But they're looking for it now. It's a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs.
They're just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll make it a second down.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I had a really difficult time. But now you get to sit up here with me. Yeah, that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game. That's a nice second down.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Not too many more ideal situations in 2nd and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. First down throw, locked. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll be a 2nd down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll come out in the pistol.
Monday.
The throw on 2nd down as well. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there, and have that what he did after the kick.
Get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
A minute 58 to go in this first half of play. We're back to Soldier Field following this short break. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs.
Let's go! Let's go! Game time!
Let it roll!
Check safety!
Hurry! Alert! Hurry!
This is our time!
And they're going to go soft on the corners.
Watch the
ship! On first down, Locke. Over the middle, Dorsett. And he's brought down. 13 yards there on the pickup. And it's good enough for an Indianapolis first down. And now the passing game here in the 2nd quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now's a play caller. Because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Alert!
Joker!
59.
Kill!
Hurry!
25! Check 25!
From the red zone now. This will be caught at about the 6. He's brought down. Well, Kansas City found the formula for shutting down T.Y. Hilton because he just had 20 yards, 1 catch in week 8.
That means someone can get some sleep this week because every slot corner that has to face T.Y. Hilton during the year, they don't sleep that week. Look what he's done already. 133 yards in week 7, had 171 in week 5. He's been something else. So kudos to Kansas City for finding a way to slow him down.
Yardage to the 5. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down.
He ain't going nowhere.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
Three down.
Takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Jack Doyle from 4 yards out. And the Colts have got it back to a one-score game.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Bears' offense now heading back out onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Alert! Three down!
Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Throw on first down with Cutler. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll bring up a second down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down. Now the Bears' sixth-round pick in 2014, Pat O'Donnell on to punt. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So here's the Bears' offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that.
Who there?
Gun.
Switch it.
Red.
Goose.
Today, 180.
Throwing now, Cutler on first down. Now he's up it underneath to his running back, complete. It's a gain of 7, and it'll make it a second down.
I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. Now Cutler and Miller with it over the middle. A good pick up there, 26 yards. offense lining up first and 10.
We go to work.
Red.
Get out of
here. 180.
57 to Mike. 57.
On first down, it's got it. Looking to catch over the middle. They give him 15 more, and it's another first down. And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able to beat the man coverage for the completion.
Second and manageable. Just found a hole in that zone.
Hey. Four down.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy. Let him pick up the first down.
Again, we'll see the pistol here.
Gun.
Check.
Miller, the man in motion. Time running out here on the play clock. And able to break one tackle, but this quickly brought down. A nice little gain. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and 2.
Exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned. Because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And he'll find his man on the out route. That's Allen. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 11 on the game there. And the Colts are going to have a first. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Hey, check.
Go, let's go. Monday.
And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. On first down, it's Lent. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards. Now the Bears electing to call a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Let's go, D. one,
check 31, check 31.
Sam.
Check three, check three.
Tell the people what you were ribbing me about before the game, and that was my Super Bowl picks.
Now that we're I didn't tell you to do that.
We're halfway through the season, but I had picked preseason Carolina and Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh's 4-3, but Carolina 2-5.
Yeah, I love the way that you just gave yourself up like that. I wasn't going to do that, but look, they're not out of it yet. The NFC South and Carolina, remember, they're used to getting on big runs, and they had a big win last week against Arizona. For me, I had Green Bay and New England. New England's looking real strong. Green Bay struggling with injuries. And Minnesota, they're the team to beat in the NFC North right now.
I really picked New England and Dallas. It just came out wrong.
I gotcha.
A good pick up there. 26 yards. First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Let's go, stands, make some noise!
And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. 2 yards on the pick up there. It'll be second and 8.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're not doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and all the plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
On second down, here's Ruff. Looking for Allen, he's got him on the slant. And he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end. A guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight. Doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
Quick, quick.
Let's go, baby. Get hot. Get up. Let's go.
Let's go.
Watch.
From the red zone now. Long. Right back for Allen. This time he finds it complete. It's a gain of 6 on the play. And that'll bring up second down.
Not my house, baby. Not my house. Not my house.
4 yards remaining now on second down. And the defense definitely showing blitz here. One receiver left is Hilton.
Wide, 622.
Now it's locked off the bootleg. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. A pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you can see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really hard to be mad at him and yell at him for trying to make that play.
So 3rd and 5, defensively expecting pass. They've got 6 DBs out there. To the air again. He's got time in the pocket. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete. Vinatieri now on to try the field goal for the Colts. And Vinatieri's kick is good. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. A decent drive there to start the 3rd quarter. They only salvaged 3 out of it, but they do inch a bit closer.
Yeah, still lots of time to go in this one. Take the points, move on, and let your defense try to get the ball back.
And now the Bears coming out as they get ready. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up now, go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes. But I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, why not?
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
Under.
Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line. Pitches together. This is Kadeem Carey.
Go, go, go.
And he cuts it out to the sideline. He's brought down after a good game. A big play there out of the running game. 32 yards.
That looked like a two deep coverage, which we call cover two. And what that really means is you have corners, what we call rolled up in about a 5 yard area on the outside receivers. Then your safeties are back closer to the hash marks near the middle of the field, somewhere around 10 to 12 yards back. So if you can break through the first level, you've got a chance to run before you encounter any type of resistance from the safeties.
We saw the example of it right there.
Slam, slam, slam.
And a little floater there is incomplete. Kadeem carry the target out of the backfield. And it's second down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends.
We got three, fellas.
Under.
Safety creep.
Again on second and 10, it's Cutler. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And these guys are going to hand the football back as the third quarter comes to an end.
Let's go.
Oh, pick! Get him!
Watch left. He's tied right there.
He's coming.
And they're going to go soft on the corners. Back to the interception. It's long. And he's got his man in stride. Give him 18 on that one. And it'll give the Colts a first down.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them. And we run that quick cut on the slant. And oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Alert.
Mike 5'9".
Hurry.
We're
in the
rep.
This is our
rep. On first and 10. And to the right side here, it's Allen. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
Completes it to Moncrief, left side. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. Give him 7 on the play, and it's a second down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play, that's his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game. I thought guys that were over 30 weren't supposed to run the football this well in the National Football League. How about that veteran leadership, a big-time run, combined with some nice blocking by his offensive line, showing that the ins and outs of being a veteran still has his place in this league. His odometer is not totally turned over yet.
First down, run. And that is incomplete. They haven't picked him off yet. Would have been a great time for the first, but instead it's third down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands,
Ringo.
A little bit questionable.
Alert 86.
So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look, six DBs.
Right here.
We're rolling.
Hey, check 24.
Going on third down, Love. And he's got Moncrief. And he picks up the first touchdown yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. And a two-score game, obviously. Every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is that you get the third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Mike, check, 59.
Hey, tight down. There you go.
From the red zone now. Long. He couldn't quite hold it. Got a hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Just shy of the five at the six.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Play number nine set to come here on the drive on third and two.
Back.
Check 99. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
Five down.
Stand up. Hurry. They come out with one back and three times. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
When you put together a formula with a winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
One receiver left, that's Allen. Looking for Dante Moncrief that time. And it's third and short.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
They gotta have six here. It's third and goal.
Hey, guys, I got 15.
Frank Gore, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Colts able to get this back with a touchdown. And the lead is down to a field goal now. Now after the touchdown, here's Pat McAfee to kick. That'll be taken in the end zone. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Hey, we've got tight left. Watch tight end.
Key him. They isolate Jeffrey to the left side.
Switch.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll leave the throw. And he's brought down. It's a pickup of 14 there. And that leads to a Chicago first down. So they're leading. They have possession of the football. And certainly, this is where they just want to milk the clock.
Single, single. I got a single.
Gun, gun, gun.
Alert three,
alert three.
They'll throw on first down with cover. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. They get 25 yards out of that one. And it'll be a Chicago first down. A timeout called by the Colts on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Getting late here in the fourth, and if this team has any chance to win this football game, their defense obviously needs a stop here.
Safe.
And a cut to the left sideline. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. And another timeout taken by the Colts. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more, plus the two-minute warning. And we'll be back.
Rush in! Rush in! Rush in!
Rolling now, Cutler on first down. And Miller with it over the middle. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this.
Stay vigilant. Don't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
And they're able to up the lead by one more. After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital.
Get
back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, give up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. It's a pickup of 16 there that'll lead to a new set of downs. And they're going to speed things up here.
Everything about that play was beautiful. A great corner route with the receiver. Worked the defensive back inside and then worked back to the outside to the corner. But how about the throw by the quarterback? Anticipation. On the break, from inside to outside, he threw the football. As the receiver turned around, the ball greeted him.
A dump down to Turbin. And he's brought down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Someone to throw to. And his throw here's incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got
it. Strong left. Strong left.
One receiver left is Hilton.
Switch.
Now it's Lawrence. caught at the 7-yard line.
Three down.
And here he'll get it down to the 7. Seven yards on the play.
I got 15.
And that's going to lead to a third down.
This is our time.
And now they're in a hurry.
Right for it here.
And this is caught down for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet.
And there's the touchdown that they needed, so they'll celebrate. But the guys on the sidelines, they got to stay focused. The onside kick team, they need them to get the ball back.
Yeah, part one of the equation done. Now they need to convert and get that onside kick. Timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option.
Everyone's got four.
This game is done. Just break it deal and call it a day. This is carry.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
I mean, you know, I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
Second down following the run.
Tight right, tight right.
Hey, four down.
Today, 180.
52's the mic, boys, 52.
I got you.
Once again, it's carried. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, baby, that's what I'm talking about. All day.
Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Bears get the win at home as we say so long from Soldier Field.